Welcome back, students. In the last video, we have discussed about how to calculate time-based system and piece-based system. So, today we are going to talk about incentive plans. In the last video, I have told you that time-based system and the piece-based system both are not the best way to pay the remuneration or pay the wages to the workers. So, to overcome those disadvantages of those methods, incentive plans have been introduced by some management experts. So what is this incentive means? So incentive means it is a scheme plan or a program to motivate individual or group to perform. So usually this individual incentive will be given to the workers to motivate them to work. This incentive normally will be majorly it will be in the form of monetary benefits. So we can say bonus, fringe benefits. These are the some of the example of incentive plans. So in the labor wage system, to identify the cost of the labor, incentive plans are being divided according to the time base. Two scientists have given their contribution on the basis of piece. Two scientists we are going to study. Time based means they are good. Like here are given two individuals who have given the time based system of calculating the incentives. What they argued is the worker should get the normal wages. Normal wages means how many hours he is working, or whatever the hours of work, hours we have fixed for working per day, he has to get that many hours of wages compulsorily. If any employee who is working above or beyond, we have to calculate according to on the proportionate according to the, we have to pay him. So in the time-based system, we have to study Halsey plan and Rowan plan. In fixed-based system, Taylor differential piece rate system and Merritt's differential piece rate system we have to study. Yes, this is the same F.W. Taylor, who is the father of scientific management, who has given the differential on the basis of piece rate system. He has given the differential piece rate system. So these are all the engineers or workers, management level workers who have understood the understood the burden of the management as well as the pain of the workers. So that's why they have come up with some models. They have proposed some models to calculate the incentives to the employees. First, let us see the Halsey plan. So Halsey both says, as I was talking, Halsey and Rowan both says that we have to give them a normal wage, which is fixed, like how many hours he is working, that many hours of wage he has to get. Plus, if he is working well, he has to get the bonus. So for that, how to understand that the employee is working well or is performing well? So for that, what they have to do is they have to fix the standard time. They have to fix the standard time to perform the work. So any worker who is completing the work before standard time will be rewarded with the incentive. That is nothing but bonus. So standard time, say for example, to complete a mud pottery, normally a standard time is fixed as 8 hours, say for example, but the worker is taking to prepare that pottery, he is only taking 6 hours, means the additional 2 hours he'll be doing other work related to pottery. So that's 2 hours extra we can give him as a bonus. What management decides is if the employees or workers are saving time, they're performing well, we have to give them bonus. We don't want to give them bonus in a full, because we are employing them, we may incur other costs also. We have to not only think about the labor cost, we have to bother about other costs also. So we will not give them the 100% bonus. That's why Halsey plan given a solution to that, okay, you don't give the bonus, 100% bonus to the employees, at least whatever the time he's saving, 50% you give the bonus to the employee, another 50% the management can keep it. That's what the third point is. Bonus is given, which is equivalent to 50% of time saved. So in the example, I have given the person, the worker has saved 2 hours. Out of eight hours, he has worked 6 hours and he prepared or manufactured a pottery. He saved 2 hours. So 1 hour of bonus he can be given, and another 1 hour, which is the benefit which can be kept with the management. So what are the says? How to calculate? What could be the formula we can come arrive with the Halsey plan? So first we'll see how we calculate the normal wage. So I said normal wage can be calculated that the actual time employee is working into the rate per hour, what we have fixed, rate per hour. So what they have argued, both Halsey and Rowan, what they have argued, the employee should get the normal wage. He must get the normal wage. The person who is not working 8 hours, he is working only 6 hours, but he is not producing a piece of pottery also, we cannot punish him. We have to give him a normal wage. We must give him a normal wage. If the person is producing a pottery in 6 hours and also he come up with a one piece of output in 6 hours, he's saving 2 hours there. Those, for that such type of employees, we can give the bonus. How we can give the bonus? He says 50% of time saved. 50% of time saved. So students here, how we can calculate the time saved? Time saved, let us take as it is, 50% of time saved. 50% of time saved. So this should be multiplied with the rate per hour again. Is okay, should be calculated by multiplied by the rate per hour. So what is 50% of time saved? What is time saved means? I can take 50% as 1/2 here. That means the same thing. Time saved is nothing but you will be having a standard time to produce any article or any output. So in the standard time, if you deduct the actual time taken by the employee, that will become the time saved. That will become the time saved by the any employee or a worker in producing articles or outputs, reproduction. So that will be multiplied by rate per hour. So this is the bonus. So if you are putting those two, normal wage plus bonus, in the formula, substituting in the formula, the earning of an employee under Halsey plan will become, earning is equal to normal wage. Normal wage is nothing but actual time. I'm taking it in the short form. That is 80 means actual time. Actual time into rate per hour. I'm taking it as a R in a short form. Okay. So actual time into rate per hour plus bonus. So plus bonus we have to take. So bonus is nothing but half of the standard time minus actual time. That is 1/2. Standard time I'm taking as a ST short form and actual time as an AT, then into rate per hour. This is the formula we arrived at. Okay, this is the normal wage. This is the bonus part. This is the normal wage part. This is the bonus part. In the standard time minus actual time is nothing but time saved. We can write actual time into rate plus half of the time saved. Like that also we can write this formula. There's no difference between both of them. If you are getting confused at time saved, what is time saved? If you don't remember such type of to solve such type of thing, means we can directly remember this formula and solve the problem. Let us see how this Halsey plan works by taking example. I have here one example. This is the formula of Halsey plan. I have example standard time 20 hours given for the employees. Within 20 hours they have to finish the work. This is the standard time they have given. Rate per hour is fixed for rupees 50. Actual time given in hours. These are the A, B, C, D and E are the employee names. So Mr. A takes 18 hours to produce the outputs. B takes 15 hours to produce the output. C takes 12 hours to produce the output. D takes 20 hours and E takes 22 hours. If you see, by looking at the number of hours they have taken, you can easily say that A, B and C is saving the time, but D is exactly matching to the standard time. E is taking more than standard time. So we cannot punish E and D, and we could not say them that no, you people are not working well, and you're not at all working well, you're taking more than the standard time, I will not pay your wages. So that cannot be done. So that's why we are going to pay all of them a normal wage first. So according to the formula, we'll just go according to the formula. First, I'm writing actual time of A is, he has taken 18 hours. Rate per hour is fixed rupees 50. Okay. Rate per hour is fixed rupees 50 multiplied by, plus bonus we have to give him. That is 1 divided by 2, half of the time saved. So 20 hours was a standard time, 18 was a actual time taken. So I'm writing here standard time 20 hours minus actual time. Time saved would be 2 hours here into rate. Rate is given rupees 50. So this will become 950 rupees. The wage of the employee A will become 950. Now let us calculate the wage of the employee B. So he is taking actual time, he is taking 15 hours into rate is 50 plus half of the time saved. I'm taking here directly. Here I have taken 20 minus 18 like that. Now I'll take here directly that how many hours he has saved. B has taken 15 hours. In 20 hours, if 15 hours he has taken, means he has saved 5 hours time. So multiplied by rate, that is 50. So this will become rupees 875. So wage for B has become rupees 875. Okay. Next, for worker C, I'm calculating. Worker C has taken 12 hours for the completion of the work. 12 hours into rupees 50, normal wage he has to get. Then 1 by 2 of the time saved. 1 by 2 of the time saved. How much his time he has saved the time? He has saved 8 hours. So 20 hours minus 12 hours, he has stayed in the 8 hours time. Into rate is rupees 50. So this will become, his wages will become 800. Next, D. D has taken exactly 20 hours, which is a standard time. So what will we do? 20 hours into 50 rupees per hour plus bonus we have to give him. So bonus says that if you have saved time, if you have saved like standard time minus actual time, so if you have saved any time, then only we are going to give you bonus. So he did not save any time. So he has taken complete 20 hours to perform the work, so the bonus will be given to him as nil. So what would be his wages? So his wages would be 1000 rupees. Next, E is taking more than standard time. So for that, we cannot punish him. We have to give him the normal wage, which is his eligible for. Then bonus will be nil for him also. So what would be his wage? His wage will be 1100. Now, by looking at this figures, you may say that, madam, incentive plan means the people who are working well, who are performing, who are finishing the work before the standard time, they should get the more wages. But madam, you are saying that A is taking 950, B is taking 875, C is saving maximum time, but he is taking the minimum wage. And D and E are taking more wages comparison to the A, B, C. In fact, they are the good employees, not D and E. So for this, I would like to give an example. You all are cricket fans, right? If in the cricket, say 50 overs match, you have a target of 250 runs made by England. Now India comes to a bat in the second innings to chase the 250 targets. It plays for 20 hours with the 0 wicket down, means 10 wickets in hand. And it has scored already 150, and rain stops the match. According to Duckworth-Lewis, who will be the winner? Definitely India, because we have 10 wickets in hand, another 30 overs to complete the another 100 runs. So, like Duckworth-Lewis method, here also we'll have to think about the average of the time they are saving. So, see here, A, he complete it in producing article at 18 hours. What he can do, the extra 2 overs he has saved, he'll start producing the another article. Again, like B also, in 5 hours he'll not sit idle, because I have completed, I can't sit idle now. No, he can't sit idle. He will take another article for the production, and he'll produce the another unit. C also produce, he'll not sit idle for the 8 hours. He'll also take the another article in the production. So if you see like that, now we have to take the, let us take an example of the person who has used minimum time to produce. I will explain you how this will work. What would be the take home of Mr. C and what would be the take home of Mr. E? How by hourly wages it will change. So 800 amount he is getting. If you divide this 800 divided by 12, so 12 for 12 hours only he is taking 800, that will become 66.67. Now we'll see for the our employee who are a least performer. So for him it will become rupees 50. See, rupees 50 is a rate per hour. He can only take the normal wage to his home, but C is taking 66.67 per hour wage to his home. So at the end of the day, in his pocket, there will be a 1,334 rupees. And in his pocket, it will be 1,100 rupees. So who is taking more? B. That is C. C will be taking 1,334 rupees, while the bad performer or a performer who is a slow worker, we cannot say bad performer, we can say the worker who is a slow worker. So he will be taking only 1,100 to the home, but at the end of the day, C will be taking the maximum amount. So we should not discuss our, by seeing this, we cannot decide that the person is taking more and the person is taking less. So for that only, we have a formula which is called as effective
rate. So effective wage rate, we say that. So effective wage rate would be is equal to total earnings divided by time taken to produce that earnings. So this is the effective wage rate. So to decide, we have to see who is taking more or who is taking less. What is the exact wages, who is taking through their pocket? We have to see the effective wage rate, not the normal rate per plus bonus. So by seeing this, we can decide that which employee should be given more wages and which employee is a good performer. Like that. I have one example here. This type of examples may be asked in your exam. I have written the formula already. Let us see the problem first. Standard time allowed for a job is 20 hours at the rate of rupees 2 plus DA at 60 paise plus DNS allowance. They are giving 2 rupees per hour plus DA of 60 paise per hour. Actual time taken by a worker is 15 hours. Calculate his earning under Halsey plan and also calculate the effective rate per hour. Now students, let us solve the formula. I have given here the formula also. According to a Halsey plan, we have the formula actual time into rate plus half of the 50% of the time saved into rate per hour. Now we'll just substitute everything in the formula. So what is the actual time he has taken? 15 hours into rate is rupees 2, okay, plus 1/2, half of the time saved. Your time saved is 5, but I will write standard time minus actual time. Let us not get confusion. Into rate, that is rate is rupees 2. Rupees 2. So 50% of this. So what will be the earnings of an employee here? The earnings will be, I'm not saying it here total earnings, it's just an earnings which normal wages plus bonus. So normal wage plus bonus, it will become rupees 35. Rupees 35 will be the earnings of a employee here. Now we have something here, that is DA. They are asked us to calculate. They are giving us 60 paise DA also. How to calculate the DA now? So his earning is not only 35 rupees, he is also getting a DA per hour also. So per hour means his actual time, what he is working into DA rate. So actual time he is working 15 hours into DA rate is 0.6 rupees, that is 60 paise. That will become rupees 9. What will be the total earning of that particular employee? It will be earnings plus DA, that is 35 rupees plus 9 rupees, that is equal to 44 rupees. Now problem will not stop here only. It also says is to calculate the effective rate per hour. Here I have given effective wage rate, the same formula I'm copying here. How to calculate the effective rate per hour? So effective rate per hour, to calculate that, we need to know the total earnings. We know the total earnings, that is rupees 44. Rupees 44 is the total earning. So I'm taking total earning here. So total earning would be rupees 44. Divided by time taken. Time taken is nothing but the actual time the employee worked. Okay. The answer would be So effective wage draft of an employee per hour is 2.93. This is how we have to solve the problem.
Welcome back, students. In the last video, we have discussed about the Halsey plan. Now we are going to discuss about the Rowan plan. Rowan plan is an extension version or a modification version of a Halsey plan. This is similar to Halsey plan, but there is a little modification in that. What is the modification? Let us see. As we have seen three rules in the Halsey plan. Similarly, in Rowan plan also, three rules are there. As Halsey argued that the worker should get the normal wage. They should not be deprived of their normal wage. How many hours they have worked, they have to pay the salary or the wages for the those many hours. As Halsey, Rowan also similarly argued that normal wage must be given to employees. For the employees or workers who are performing well, who are finishing their work before the standard time, they'll be given with the bonus. So for that, we have to fix the standard time. As the point one says, the standard time is fixed to perform the work. Next point says, any worker who is completing the work before standard time will be rewarded with the incentive, that is bonus. Bonus is paid on the basis of time saved in proportion to the total time set as a standard. This is an important point. In the Halsey plan, what we have given, bonus is given the 50% of the time saved we have given as a bonus. Say for example, in the last video also I was giving the example, 8 hours is a standard time fixed. If 8 hours is a standard time fixed, if the worker is completing his duty or his completing his work on sixth hour only, means he's taken 6 hours to complete, actually taken 6 hours to complete the work, the remaining 2 hours which he has saved out of 8 hours will be considered for the bonus. In that 2 hours, 50% of the bonus only will be given. So 2 hours, in 2 hours, 50% means 1 hour is eligible to get the, for 1 hour he is eligible for to get the bonus. So 1 hour, what is the rate of that hour we are paying? So we will give the 1 hour into rate of that hour. So we will give the bonus as the, under the Halsey plan. Under Rowan plan, bonus is paid in proportion to the time saved to the standard time, means how much standard time we have fixed, in proportion to that, how much time he has, the employee has saved. So that much bonus we are giving here. So what would be our formula comes? Let us derive the formula. So earnings will become normal wage plus bonus. So normal wage he must get, every worker should get the normal wage, whether he is saving the time or not saving the time, or he is exceeding the standard time. So we need not to worry about it, but we have to pay the worker how many hours of work he is doing. So that says the normal wages. The workers who are performing well and who are producing the output within the standard time, or they are saving the time, for them we have to give the bonus. So earnings is equal to normal wage says actual time into rate plus bonus. So bonus says, in the third point we say, the proportionate to the time saved is proportion to the standard time. So time saved divided by standard time into actual time into rate. This is the bonus portion. So therefore, the earnings under the Rowan method will become normal wage plus the bonus. So normal wage portion is this one, and the bonus portion will be this one. So normal wage is actual time into rate. Bonus is standard time minus actual time, that is nothing but the time saved, divided by the standard time into actual time into rate. To understand this, let us take an example. and we will work out that example. Calculate the total earning of a worker under Rowan plan if he completes a piece of work in 60 hours. Means actually he's taking 60 hours to complete a output, to produce output. How much he is taking? He's taking it 60 hours as against 75 hours allowed. So 75 hours allowed means this is a standard time which is set by the organization, company or a factory. His hourly rate is 25 paisa. So what is the hourly rate he has given? 25 paisa per hour the employees or a worker is getting paid. He gets a DA also. He gets a earner's allowance per day of 8 hours at rupees 1. So he's getting a DA per day. Per day DA will be 1 rupees. Per day he's working 8 hours. So 8 hours a day he's working. For that 8 hours he's getting 1 rupees DA also. 1 rupee DA also. So I have jotted down the all the data given, that is standard time. It's mean standard time 75 hours. Actual time 60 hours. Then rate per hour 25 paise. DA, I have calculated the DA here. See, DA they have given for one day, that is 8 hours of day, they have given 1 rupee. Here we have to calculate the DA per hour basis because we are calculating everything per hour here. So that's why we have to convert the day DA into a hourly based DA. So for 8 hours, 1 rupee DA is given. So for 1 hour, how much DA would arrive? So for 8 hours a day, 8 hours of a day, he is getting a 1 rupee as a DA. For 1 hour, how much DA he will get? So the cross multiply, so 1 into 1 divided by 8. So for 1 hour, the employee would get 0.125 as a DA. So let us substitute all the values in the formula. Let us take first actual time. Actual time is 60 hours into rate per hour is, rate per hour given is 25 paise plus standard time is 75 hours minus 60 hours is actual time. This is proportionate. This is time saved. 75 minus 60 is nothing but time saved, which is proportionate to the standard time, that is 75 hours. 75 hours is the standard time into, again, actual time. Actual time is 60 hours into, actual time is 60 hours into rate per hour would be 25 paise. So this is the substitution of values into the formula. What will be the answer? So 60 into 25 will become 15 plus 75 by 60 will become 15, which is divided by standard time, that is 75 hours, okay, into 60 into 0.25 will become 15. Okay, this is the second level calculation. Finally, we will arrive at the, so like 15 plus 15 by 75 would become 0.2 into 15. That will be rupees 18 is the earnings for the total earnings of a, rupees 15 is a earning of a particular employee. Now this is not the total earning. So he's getting the DA also. So how much DA is getting? He's getting DA 1.125. So we have to calculate, we have to add the DA also. DA is equal to actual time into DA rate. So actual time taken by an employee is 60 hours into DA rate is, to DA rate is how much? 0.125. That will become 7.5. So the total earnings of an employee will become, total earning of a worker is equal to earnings by using Rowan method plus DA. That is nothing but earnings is earnings which I have given, earnings which we have calculated, rupees 18 here, plus the DA 7.5. This total earning will become 23.5. This is total earnings. This is how we calculate, we work out the problem under Rowan plan. In examination, we make it the problems to work out under both Halsey and Rowan plan. So for example, if they have given 5 to 6 employees or 3 to 4 employees and they ask you to calculate the total earnings for the both the for the all 4 employees or 6 employees, you may consume time to calculate both the methods for the 4 to 5 employees, and it consumes time also, it consumes the paper in the exams also. So for that, I have worked out a format where you can calculate both the methods of all the employees. Let us take an example to understand this, how to calculate, how to shorten the time in calculating in the exam, in calculating the both the methods. Standard time fixed for a job in a manufacturing concern is 40 hours. So standard time is 40 hours. Time rate is 60 paise per hour. They are paying 60 paise per hour. The actual time taken by the worker A, worker B and worker C is 20 hours, 15 hours and 30 hours respectively. Calculate the total remuneration of A, B, C under Halsey and Rowan plan. So they have given three workers A, B and C. We have to calculate both under Halsey plan also and under the Rowan plan also. So students, if you remember Halsey plan and Rowan plan formula, you can easily calculate the total wages. I have given a table here, calculation of total wages. So in the both the of problems, we have common things, like I'll write Halsey formula, that is actual time into rate plus the bonus, that is time saved into rate, that is half of the time saved into rate. The time saved is nothing but, if you want me to put it in the form, not to get confused, so standard time minus actual time into rate. So this is the formula for we've used for Halsey method. In Rowan method, what formula we have used? We have used this formula. Okay. We have used this formula. So what we are seeing here, we have a common thing, that is the required entries are actual time, standard time and the rate. So in the both the formulas, the entries are same. That is, we are using only actual time. We want standard time data. We want rate per hour. So by using this table, we can easily save the time in calculating under both Halsey and Rowan plan. See, I have written the common things, which is particulars. This is employee A, employee B and employee C. So standard time actual time. I have taken the data. So standard time is given 40 hours. Standard time fixed for a job in manufacturing concern is 40 hours. This 40 hours is same for all the workers in the factory. So whether it is A, whether it is B, C or many others. So standard time will be fixed, which is 40 hours. So 40 hours is fixed for all the workers. So actual time what they have taken will differ from employee to employee or worker to worker. So A has taken 20 hours, B has taken 15 hours and worker C has taken 30 hours. So I have written here actual time 20 hours, 15 hours, 30 hours which they have taken to perform the work. Now we have to calculate the time saved. Time saved is nothing but standard time minus actual time, that is this row minus this row. So standard time minus actual time, 40 minus 20, 20 is time saved, 40 minus 50, 25 hours is time saved, 40 hours minus 30 hours, 10 hours is the time saved by the employee or worker C. So this is the time saved by the different employees. Now rate. Rate is given. Rate is fixed for all the employees. That is 60 paise per hour. I have written rate here. That is 0.6, 0.6, 0.6. All the employees are getting per hour 0.6 only. There is no difference in this. Again, I am repeating students. I have taken standard time straight away 40 for everybody because standard time is fixed for all the workers in any particular organization. Actual time, whichever the worker has taken, how many hours I have taken here. So time saved, I have taken this minus this. That is standard time minus actual time. This row minus this row, I have written here the time saved. Rate per hour, which is given in the problem, for rate per hour is fixed for all the employees. It is not going to change from employee by employee. So this is the 0.6, that is 60 paise per hour. I have written rate per hour it is. Now, step one I'm taking. Step one is we have to calculate in the both the formulas, we have to calculate the normal wages first, that is actual time into rate. So I am taking your normal wage, that is actual time into rate. Actual time is in my row 2 and rate is in my row 4. So I am multiplying this row with this row. So that is, that will become actual time is 20, rate per hour is 60 paisa, that will become 12. So actual time is 15, rate per hour is 60 paise, that will become rupees 9. Actual time taken by an employee is 30, so rate per hour is 60 paise, so for C it will become 18. Students, this is the normal wage all the employees is going to take home. So this is the normal wage which are eligible. They must, or the organization must give this wage to the employee. So after normal wages, we have to calculate the bonus. Now the second part, in the Halsey part, this second part is a bonus. In the Rowan part also, in a Rowan formula also, the second part is a bonus. So first I'm taking the Halsey plan, that is a step two, bonus under Halsey plan. So bonus under Halsey plan says half of the time saved into rate, half of the standard time minus actual time into rate. So half is nothing but 0.5 also you can take, 50% also you can take, or 1/2 also you can take. Everything is same. Time saved into rate. Students, look here. Time saved is already I have calculated in row 3. So for A, 20, B, 25, C, 10. We already calculated the time saved. We already have the rate also. We have already entered the rate also in the fourth column. So just we have to multiply 20 into 0.6 and divided by 2. So this is how we have to take half of the 20 into 0.6 divided by 2. If you are getting doubt, I can solve one or two here. So under step 2, how I have calculated? Step 2 I have calculated. I have taken 1/2 into time saved. That is standard time minus actual time. Standard time minus actual time it is, which is for A, it is 20 here. So I am taking 20 into rate is 0.6. So this is step two, how it looks like. Okay, so next for the same for the B, it is 25, which is time saved. Okay, then the rate is 0.6, 25 into 0.6 divided by 2 into half, or else. Next, 10 is the time saved, rate is 0.6, time saved into rate 0.6 divided by 2. So we'll get bonus as 20 into 0.6 divided by half is 6. Okay, 25 into 0.6 divided by half will be 7.5. Again, 10 into 0.6 divided by half would be rupees 3. This is the bonus and Halsey plan. Okay, next step 3 would be bonus under Rowan. So bonus under Rowan, what it says, time saved proportion to the standard time into actual time into rate. So I'm calculating for the employee 3 here to show how I have calculated step 3, that is bonus under Halsey plan. So if you see here in the table, we can see that time saved we already have here in this column, that is 20 hours. In 20 hours, I have to divide the 20 hours divided by first row, that is 40. So here I'm taking time saved divided by standard time, that is equal to time saved. Here I have 20 for A and standard time is 40. Okay, so here 20 divided by 40. So after that, what we have in the Rowan formula, time saved divided by standard time. After that, we have actual time into rate. So into actual time into rate. I think by 20 divided by 40, that is into actual time. What is actual time taken by the A? 20 hours. Rate is 0.6. So this is how the calculation goes here. For step 3, bonus under the Rowan time saved, that is in the third row answer. For all these three answers are time saved, which you should multiply, which you should divide by standard time, that is 40 hours for all three workers, into actual time, that is second column, into rate, that is fourth column. And now let us see how it will come. And bonus under the Rowan plan. So time taken, standard time 40, actual time 20, so time saved will be 20. 20 divided by 40 into 0.6. Okay. Again here, time saved 25 divided by 40 into 15 into 0.6. Next. For C, time saved is 10 divided by standard time 40 into actual time 30 into 0.6. So the answer would be 4.5. So now you can calculate the total wages. Total wages is nothing but normal wage plus bonus. Normal wage plus bonus will be your total wages. So where we have this data? Normal wage we have in step 1. Okay, so for both, for Rowan also and for Halsey also, we have common, that is step 1, we have to add. Okay, so step 1 plus step 2. So step 1 for Halsey plan, step 1 normal wages 12 plus bonus under Halsey plan, that is 6, it will become 18. Next, for the employee B, normal wages 9 plus bonus under Halsey 7.5, that will become 16.5. For C, employee C, normal wages is 18 plus bonus under Halsey plan 3, that will become 21. Similarly, Rowan, for Rowan plan, normal wages is 12 for A and bonus is 6. So 12 plus 6, 18. Okay. Next, B, normal wages plus bonus under Rowan. That will be 14.625. For C, normal wages 18 plus bonus under Rowan plan. That will be 4.5. So the answer will be 22.5. So if you work out with the calculator by using this format, it will not only save pages and it will also save your time and repetition of writing the formulas and all. You can directly write the formulas under Halsey. We are using this formula, and under Rowan plan, we are using this formula. If you write at the top of your table, and if you follow this table, you can calculate for multiple workers. You can calculate both the, not only for 3, if they have given 6 or 7, you can easily calculate for all the 7 employees simultaneously by using your calculators. It will become very helpful. This is all about. I'll